Hey everybody, John Lum, you can call me John L. We are on to Mega Man 7. This is the first and only, I believe, Mega Man for Super Nintendo. Mega Man X, I think there was maybe one or two, I'm not quite sure. Three, four, I don't know, on the Super Nintendo. But I know there's only one Mega Man on the Super Nintendo and we were playing it. It's a fun game, it's awesome, it's definitely an evolution from what it was in the Nintendo. There's more story and scenes and stuff like that, so it takes a little bit longer. I found it to be a pretty easy game until the end when it gets very hard. So, we're just gonna get into it. Alright. And I will try to fast forward through as much stuff as we can. So, yeah, as you can see, they definitely set this up in graphics and sound and everything, and now, instead of just hitting the start button and going to the robot boss select screen, you got some story elements here. And you can't fast forward through it. That's okay. Mega Man 7 now with jokes. So they added a lot of stuff. The guy driving the truck with the eyeballs, auto. It's a cool new feature. He has a shop, you can buy E-tanks and lives and power-ups and stuff like that. Escape. Look. Just watching this stuff happen. Wily. Upgraded for 16-bit. You gotta go now, Mega Man. Get Rush and follow Wily's spaceship. Right, I want some action. So they have this like little lead-in section here. I'll be honest, I'm not very good at this guy. Maybe I am. There you go. Okay, that's honestly the best I've ever done against that guy. Alright. There's bass and treble. So much talking in the beginning. Why is there so much talking? Better tell me who you are. Stop Wily while you're gone. He was in prison though, isn't he? Dot dot dot. Can't speed through that, and it's like by the speed of like the text they expect you to read like a third grader or something. Alright, so you get four bosses at a time. So, I've played through this a couple times, and it takes me about an hour, through each four, the four, and then the next four, and then Wily's Castle, takes me about an hour. So we're gonna take a break after every four bosses, and right before Wily's Castle. So the levels are definitely more colorful. So with this game, there's a lot of kind of hidden and additional items. It's almost like everything that they had in like the first six Mega Man games, they crammed into this one. So Beat's in here, Rush and his, you know, different abilities are in here. E-Tanks, W-Tanks, S-Tanks. They added a Rush Search. I don't go for that. So there's a lot of stuff, a lot of power-ups and additional stuff. There's an E-Tank we just got there. And there's actually a little bit of backtracking. I guess you could get through this game without having to do any backtracking. I'm not quite sure. I haven't tried to do it. When you fight the bosses with the correct weapons, they're definitely way easier. So that's what I've been doing. But if you wanted to, and you were good, you know, the bosses have patterns and you can absolutely kill them with the Buster. And that'll probably save you like a couple of trips through some of the levels to do some of the backtracking that you need to pick up some of this stuff. So I'm always a little bit nervous on the stage because spike ceilings, right? Okay, so now there's mid-bosses too. So this guy is easy enough to kill if you just shoot him. Oh boy. And then they got the rising water part here. So they added these bolts, and you can use them to buy, that's the currency that you use to buy stuff in Auto Shop, which is really cool because it just makes the game easier. You don't have to really worry too much about holding on to E-Tanks. So this section's a little bit tough because that water's buoyant, I guess. So Mega Man will float. For that, you gotta just get the jump right there. But, you can't actually jump higher until the water gets to a certain level, so you have to kind of wait. Oh boy. Oh boy. Alright, reset. This level is kind of the de facto starting level. Oh boy! Come on. Alright. I was gonna say, don't put me in the water. So, nothing's really too challenging on this level, I just missed that jump right there. Oh. So you can just see from the menu here that there's just a ton of stuff. Oh yeah, and they have rush plates, kind of like the beat plates. So that's something you have to collect, and that's one of the things we'll have to go back to the level to do. Spikes, but you definitely can hit the bottom spikes. Alright. So Burst Man is actually pretty easy. I think there's probably better strategies than what I do with the Buster. My strategy is just press the button a lot, and he goes down pretty okay. You just need to make sure that the bubbles he makes come up from the ground don't drive you into the spikes in the ceiling. Like that. And he also does this. So as long as you kind of don't get smashed into the ceiling, it's not so bad. And run into him a lot. I know I could charge up, but easy enough. One of the reasons why I don't charge up is also you need to shoot yourself out of those bomb balloons or bomb bubbles that he creates, so feels good enough. Out a bomb encased in a bubble, doesn't it? Alright, so I have my cheat sheet of where the stuff is in the levels, even though I've played this game through a couple times. So Cloud Man, there's a couple things we'll need to come back for. There's a Mega Bolt, which I've never actually found, and the Proto Shield thing, and the Super Adapter. Super adapter part will need freeze. Cutter shoot we can get. Okay. So I'm just wondering, again, it takes me about an hour to go through four of these guys, and I'm wondering if a good chunk of that is all this extra animation that has been going on, or that they added to the game. Oh shit. Okay, I'm not lucky. Not like I'm particularly great at any of this stuff, but I want to say stuff popping out of the ground and spikes are like the number one things that kill me. The number one and two things that kill me. Yeah, so we're gonna want to shoot that guy with Freeze Cracker when we get it, so that way we can get the rush. It's not like the Mega Man games have been really like drab or bland, but this is definitely a bit more colorful than I think the other Mega Mans have been. It's nice. I think a lot of these levels have quite a bit of personality in them. And I don't know if they had the extra storage and the Super Nintendo cartridges, but, you know, I feel like some of the levels are a bit longer, too. They've definitely added, like, a lot more stuff in the levels. There's a lot of foreground stuff, ground stuff, like, animations for, you know, enemies and... Come on. It's a leap of faith. Yeah, so up there is, saying E-Tank, and that's where you get the rush thing. And this guy is here. Looks like they added they brought back a ton of stuff, they added a lot of stuff. Over here is where that Mega Bolt should be, the one that I've never found. Doing very well with those egg guys here. Fan guys. Alright. I'm always just scared for these last jumps. Something's gonna come up and knock me off the ledge. Okay, so Cloud Man is pretty easy. Just jump over his lightning and then hit him with the danger app. And, do that a handful of times, and well, more than a handful. It's kind of a timing thing, like you have to wait a second, then hit him. See, and that's what I like too. The weapon that is kind of specific to the boss has kind of a little special animation that it does. And the patterns are pretty easy. I would say they're kind of like on par with like Mega Man 6 bosses. Like, this guy's not trying to run into me or anything, he's just kind of doing his thing, and... yep, that's it. Cool, so that's two down. Bolt. Okay, so then next is junk. Power machine. So on Junk Man, we'll get Rush Jet. There's a Mega Bolt, which we can't get. Oh, we didn't do the Proto Shield for Cloud. Okay. Well, we have to come back to Cloud Man stage anyways, so we can do it then. Mega Bolt, and oh, there's a Super Dapper piece, which we can't get until we get Freeze. Alright, so we're just gonna work on getting a Rush Jet. And killing him. So I think what's cool also is, you know, obviously This is a Mega Man on a different system, but, you know, despite the improved graphics and everything, the feel is the same. So, you know, I just finished playing Mega Man 6, all the other NES Mega Mans, and he jumps, he shoots, all the timing, all that kind of stuff, feels the same, which is nice. And we're gonna shoot right there so that we can get to the get to the rush bit and Mega Bolt. Alright. So over here is where we will be able to get the rush jet. So another thing cool about this is all the bolts you collect, you can actually buy all these upgrades from Auto if you can't find them, but it definitely pays off to try to find them so you can save the money for E-Tanks and all that kind of stuff later on. So it is right here. And I'm just gonna use a rush bolt. So yeah, you can kind of easily get squished over there. Alright, same thing over there. Okay, this portion I kind of have some problems with sometimes, so let's try to get through it as best we can. There's a section with right here. These platform guys. And yeah. So we can kill this guy. Garbage falls, and then we jump. Okay, cool. All right. Whoa. Ah. Okay. We made it. That garbage has killed me more times than I like to admit. Okay. So we don't have a whole lot of life, but Junkman's pretty easy. So if you can tag him with Thunderbolt really early, he gets into this pattern where he's gonna jump at you and throw something down. All you need to do is slide out of the way, hit him with Thunderbolt when he lands, and he'll do the exact same thing. So hopefully we can do this kind of clean and And again, it's like one of those, like, you gotta wait a second type thing. And Thunder takes a lot off of him, so you only need to hit him with, like, a couple. So, there you go, Junkman. So the levels, I think if you can get through them, aren't too long, but again, with the addition of like all the story and text and stuff, and then the backtracking, kind of adds up a little bit. So you get the jump shield. Doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. So with freeze, we will get the rush search, which is definitely valuable. We'll get the exit, which is awesome. It lets you just leave a level at any moment. And there's a super adapter piece. Oh, okay, that we can get. So I think we can get everything out of this level.
Yeah, I don't remember how to backtrack.
We might have to backtrack.
You kind of have to get the rush thing with one shot. And if I can't, then I'll need to, like, it's on a disappearing platform that does not reappear when you change screens, which kind of sucks, so. I really like the polar bears. I don't know why. They just look cool. Spikes make me nervous. Yeah, so there's a platform just like that, and that's what the rush stuff is on. You know what? Screw this. Can fix that. Please don't get hit. Okay, so right up here is where we will attempt to get the rush thing. Yes! Alright, we made the jump. Okay, we don't have to come back. Well, we might have to come back. Who knows? Alright, I think we're okay. Search. Alright, hopefully that's coming up. It is right here. Alright. I don't want to mess around with this anymore. Whoa, what was that? Alright, cool. So now we have rush search. So now, we can use him to sniff around on the ground, and he can dig up items, sometimes junk, sometimes cool stuff like extra lives and whatnot. So it's a cool feature that they added for this game, actually. Kind of like it. When I was playing through earlier, I kind of didn't get the locations right for some stuff and ended up getting a whole bunch of extra lives and goodies and stuff, so it's kind of cool. Okay, so it's the second step. Come on. Bad timing. Okay, cool. A little life now? Alright.
Whoa, hello. Alright, whoa, come on. Okay, so this is the part where they have the annoying ski bobsled bombs. Ugh. And right over here is the exit, so we will use rush search. So he's gonna do his little sniffing thing, and... So I think the way it works is, when he finds something cool, he lets out all the barks. And then if he can't find it, he'll still be pointing in the direction that it is, so sometimes you'll have to, like, deploy him a couple times. Alright, so I don't know if I have enough to do this, but I need to use jump shield. I'm actually gonna go ahead and use an E-tank if I kinda suck it up, so. There's kind of a pattern to him, you just wanna kinda run into him with jump shield, but he drops icicles and does stuff, and I never really paid attention. I just kind of run into him, so I kind of take a lot of damage. Oh. Alright, we'll see how this goes. Okay, the ice is not that bad. Alright, sucks, but... So you can only carry 4 E-tanks, and at the end, you really wish you could carry more. So I guess get hit by the icicles seems to do, like, not very much damage. But yeah, so you can carry 4 E-tanks and 1 S-tank, which will refill everything, and... The good thing is you can just keep rebuying them through auto, but... So I guess it's kind of cool, with the first 6 Mega Mans, I guess if you were interested in the story, you just needed to read it from the manual. This one is kind of like the evolution of storytelling where, you know, it's kind of integrated more into the game. Attacking the Robot Museum. So we need to go back to Clown Man, and we need to go back to Jump Man. So I like this level because, one, they have all the classic bosses here. You see Snake Man and Blizzard Man and Plant Man and Yamato Man back there and Flame Man, Pharaoh Man, Beat Man. Like a real emphasis on like the Mega Man 6. And then the Guts Man music, you know, just kind of new remix, so it's pretty awesome. This boss, though, gives me, like, a little bit of a problem, so... I have 1 E-tank, hopefully that's enough. There's Skull Man, Ring Man, Guts Man, of course, right there. Pretty cool. Nice touches. And there's this thing, this monstrosity. Oh boy. Oh boy.
can we do better? Otherwise, this is gonna be a long fight. Oh boy. See, I told you I suck. Yeah, you just gotta hit your shots on that one. I mean, don't really know what else to say about that. Now these robots are rampaging through the middle of the city. Kinda wish you could speed up the text. Okay, cool. Alright, so they add the next four, but we're gonna go back and pick up some of the stuff we missed. But this won't take long because we have the exit, so we don't have to run through the whole level. Hit this guy with a charged up buster. So we get rain. And we can get an extra life here. And we want to hit this guy with freeze cracker. And now we'll get snow. So that's another cool thing too. So I want to say that there's kind of more puzzle elements to this. Get every bolt you can. Just disappeared, huh? All right. Ooh. Okay, and we want to get to the screen with the snowy platforms. Which is right here. It's definitely easier to see this stuff right here. So we will get another extra life. And then we will jet over here and pick up a U. Cool, so we have three of the plates now. Careful, because we don't like dying. Oh boy. Oh, come on. Okay, and we need to do the Proto Man thing.
Bastard.
There you go. Mega Bolt.
Heal up. Stink face. Alright, so this ladder that we didn't go up initially is where we meet Proto Man, and it's also where there might be... Yes, yet I don't get it. He does this, and I just don't know. I've never ever gotten the... thing, the Mega Bolt. Okay, it's obviously not there. I just don't know. Never found it. He just kind of like goes crazy there and never decides to dig, so... Hidden areas. Try using the flame weapon in the woods. That's how you get beat. Okay, and I think we are done. So yeah, we did the proto shield part, can't find the mega bolt, and we got the super adapter bit. So now we can use the exit, and then just get out of here. So now we'll go to Junkman and pick up all the things that we need to pick up. Yeah. It's one thing I just don't like about the roaches. They are low, so you need to actually use the, charged up blast to get them, because they're just below the, your Mega Cluster shot. Freeze right here, and we can sneak in and drop down here, but we use freeze here too, and now we have the S bit. Okay, and that actually gives us the super adapter, so now he can jump and whatever, double jump. That one. Okay, so there's a Mega Bolt here. So we'll use Rush Search. Okay. See, and this is kind of what normally happens. A bar kill dig. Boom, Mega Bolt. Okay, cool. So, the Mega Bolt, we have Rush Jet, we got the Super Adapter. That should be the end of what we need to do here. So now I'll just use exit. Okay. So I'm going to stop the recording, take a little break. When we get back, we'll do Slash Man, Spring Man, Shade Man, and Turbo Man. So I'll see you guys in a little bit.